Hi everyone, hope you're doing well from whenever you're watching this channel, depending on the time zone. Now, we have youth who are on street protesting, but it seems some members of parliament are too ignorant to see, read the mood and understand why the youth are on street so that they can gauge their words, their speech, when they go to the public. And one of the leaders who has really failed in a big way to learn a lesson is the Sabaja Member of Parliament, Clement Sloyer. Clement Sloyer is representing Sabatia constituency, where Mudavadi used to be a member of parliament. This man voted yes on finance bill. Even after making that mistake, he did not learn a lesson. He still comes back and he won't explain to the people on the ground why he voted yes, thinking he can confuse them with the reasons why he voted yes. He was silenced, he was booed, and he had no any other option but to leave that event.
Na hiyo inatoka kwa tax. Sasa hiyo finance bill ikikuja bungeni, mimi wakati nikipiga yes nilikuwa napiga yes kwa sababu ya yale manufaa nilikuwa nimepata ndani peke yake. Usipige kelele tafadhali. Mimi nataka kueleza kwa sababu yale ambayo mimi nimeona ndani.
Now, we are continuing with this particular discussion, but just a quick request for those who are watching and you've not yet subscribed, please consider subscribing. To our channel subscribers, I must say thank you so much, and again to all our viewers, please give this video a thumbs up. Thank you so much, and back to this discussion. Now, if Clement's lawyer was a smart person, because he's a youthful leader, there is many things that youth were expecting from him being a youthful leader. He should have learned a lesson from P.K. Selassie, the Mias East Member of Parliament. Despite working even with Oscar Sudi, Rigathi Gachagua and other leaders closely, still he knew the demand from the ground. People did not want finance bill, so he voted a big no and he made sure that it is being captured on his TikTok. Today, if Peter Selassie will come to Sabatia, he will be welcomed so warmly. Why? Because his vote spoke to the cry of many people in this country. The youth will welcome him. But if this Sabatia MP will go anywhere, he will be chased like a Mburukeng. He did not learn a lesson. In his thinking, he thought that he is coming to address the old people who are not well informed, so that he can come and lie to them. Ata hana woga, hana ibu ya kwamba you are coming to explain the reason why you voted yes. So you want to lie in terms of this development, that development, that. My friend, even with 8% who was doing massive development, here 60% of William Ruto anataka kuipandisha, there is zero development. If I walk around, I can show you in the village here, many projects that was launched by William Ruto, and none of them has started. So he's going there to start convincing people that nilipiga yes, ndiompate maji, nilipiga yes, ndiompate barabara, nilipiga. People are saying no. Keep quiet. No one wants to listen to him. Why? Because they are well informed. Leaders must learn that the people they are leading today, they are well informed. And I saw another guy from, is it Matungu? He was explaining to the people that I will go and tell the speaker to remove my vote that I voted yes from the yes side and put on the no side. And we already voted. Yani hivi ndio wabunge wanatubeba ujinga. They see that they are on a runner, yani we are so stupid to understand. But the people of Sabatia are not stupid. These are the same people who voted out Musalia Mudavadi in 2002 election and voted in Reverend Akaranga as the member of parliament. They punished Mudavadi. Until when Mudavadi went back to ODM with Raila Odinga, it's when they forgave him. So, Clement's lawyer should know this. He ndio controller nilipiga kura ya kutoa Mudavadi kwa uongozi na wali manage. A very senior government official, a man whose father had, you know, worked so hard for this constituency. His father delivered, but for him, wakati waliona ni kama ameleta mchezo pale, walipiga out. So he's here. Let him know that the vote that he got to ascend to position of leadership as a member of parliament, it was a sympathy vote after his brother died. Because it was his brother who was really so much interested in this position, he had worked for it. But when he died, there was a kind of sympathy to return favor. So he forget how he became the member of parliament. And the people are saying on the ground, let him know that if his brother was alive today and is a member of parliament, they believe that he would have voted no because of how they knew him, a man who knew the problems of the people, a man who would want to listen to issues from the people and give a solution as far as kulingana na vile watu wanataka. He literally represented the interest or views of the people. That's why walimpenda. Na vile alikufa, wakapigia ndugu yake kura. So, the majority of the people believe that ndugu yake angekuwa hai leo, angepiga a big no. But now, this one is actually betraying the electorate who gave them, who gave him a sympathy vote. So the ground is saying a big no. I can assure you, this is the second time. First place, he sent someone to a funeral somewhere to represent him. He was just. This time around, it is himself trying to explain nonsense. He has been silenced. Let him put it down. He might not see parliament in 2027. Yes, he might not see parliament in 2027. These people voted overwhelmingly for Raila Odinga when Mudavadi was promised to be a prime cabinet secretary and campaigning for William Ruto. So, majority thought that hata kama Vihiga yote itakataa kura kupea mheshimiwa William Ruto, at least Sabatia will give William Ruto. He must go and check properly ni kura ngapi Raila alipata Sabatia na William Ruto alipata kura ngapi. So, he should know that he is talking to people who overwhelming voted for Raila, despite the fact that kulikuwa na Mudavadi akiwaambia pigia Ruto kura, they went against Mudavadi. He's forgetting all that. Sasa, he in opposition stronghold, he forget quickly, and therefore his punishment will come so quick. Haitachukua muda mrefu. So in Sabatia, where Mudavadi is coming from, they are saying no to William Ruto, they are saying no to finance bill, and that is the position of the people. Alienda kule Rift Valley akaambia watu ya kwamba eti kupiga no ni kusema mheshimiwa William Ruto, yani vote of no confidence in William Ruto. So ilikuwa ni kuashiria kwamba wapige yes so that William Ruto's presidency can be guarded. Lakini kwake nyumbani hakuna mchezo. Wanafukuza wabunge, wanawapigia kelele. They don't want them. So it's a total rejection. Kama kuna mahali Ruto alifikiria kwamba huku Western kuna his support, it is not there. Climate lawyers should have learned that even in Rift Valley, the youth are saying no to William Ruto. So how do you expect in the Western region to embrace this man who is coming up with the bills that are unfriendly to the people? So hii upuzi ya kusema ati utakuja ueleza watu wadanganye and they just support you, it is not going to work. You should be a good example to the youth, because you are a youth. But you become one of the worst examples. So the only discipline to you is to vote you out. So I can tell him here on this camera, by voting yes, definitely, he was giving a chance to the electorate to prepare for a vote, a protest vote against him in 2027. So in Sabatia constituency, there is going to be a protest vote against their member of parliament. So whoever is preparing, just come and speak the language of the people, defend the people. You will kick out lawyer from office. Simple. Hapa hakuna kazi kubwa. Kufunga hii biashara ni rahisi sana. So that is the view of the people from Sabatia. Let us meet in the comment section to continue this discussion. Thank you and see you in our next video.